My name's Lewis Stone. I train at the KFA gym, East Grinstead. I'm not sure what my opponent knows about me, but maybe he wants to have a little look at this. Training really hard for this fight, looking forward to it, and come fight night I'm going to come out on top. I don't know much about my opponent. I submitted my last one, I'm going to knock this one out. I can stand up, I can go to the ground, wherever the fight goes I will be ready. I'm looking for the knockout, so watch out, it will come.
Kudzu Gym in the blue corner, Lewis Stone, Team KFA, and this is our first professional MMA bout of the night. Over 3 5-minute rounds now. And Nick, that adds a whole new dimension to the ground games.
Absolutely. As well as the ground and pound to the head, you can also look forward to elbows and heel hooks. So a real element of danger involved.
West, the smaller, stockier fighter, might advantage with Stone. Both men nice and light on their feet, measuring each other up here.
Well, Paul West has got a dangerous straight right.
Yes, I think I was reflected in the way that Stone immediately went for the single leg. He didn't get it, but as you said, I think West looks dangerous.
Yeah, he had very quick hands, nice bounce on his feet. Lewis Stone sensed that, decided to shoot in, and here they are in pressed up against the fence with Lewis Stone looking for the takedown.
And you can see already the difference with the professionals, the cool, calm way West is assessing the situation, looking down at the options.
Oh, that was a knee to the groin there, very powerful. It lifted him off his feet. I'm sure he's going to need the full 5 minutes to recover from that one.
And Stone waves it off to West. They accept it and go again. As I said, this is a professional bout and showing true professionalism there.
Yes, Lewis is going to have to throw some punches and put that kick on the end of it because it was a bit telegraphed. Watch for the straight right of Paul West.
Yeah, and as with you, I like his foot movement in and out. A bit wild with the left, which is a shame, but as I said, can't fault the footwork.
Yes, a very back and forth style he's got there, committing to his attack. So that would be a perfect time for Lewis to shoot in underneath to get secure the takedown.
An exchange of low kicks. And then this time it's actually West that goes for the takedown.
West muffled into the floor there and is in half guard. Let's see if Lewis can use the cage to get back to his feet or at least recover guard.
Well, Paul West looking to posture up here.
Yeah, we'd like to see some elbows now. First of the evening. Lewis is reversing positions here. He should try and stand up. Paul West spins for the back. Good job by Lewis there.
Yeah, realised what he was doing there. luckily for him.
Manages to get back to the feet. Well done. Good little scramble there.
Some nice transitions there. A nice part of the fight, actually. Two nice professionals here.
Paul West seems more to be the predator, though. Backing up Lewis.
Ducked under that shot from Lewis Stone West.
He does look very powerful, does Paul West.
Oh, bolo punch, just a bit telegraphed.
Yeah, and his head's a bit low. It keeps getting wrapped up. Got to watch out for that.
Nice movement. He did take a solid knee from Lewis Stone. Paul West, you wouldn't have known it. And then nice head movement afterwards.
Very calm. This is what you can expect from the professionals. They've been there, done it. They took their beatings in the gym. They know how to relax under pressure. I'd like Paul West to throw some more. Doesn't have to commit 100% to every strike.
No, he does like to take the centre of the cage, and as you said, but at times he doesn't do anything with it. Like now, he's walked his man down perfectly again and then stops. It's frustrating.
A little bit hesitant, maybe in the later rounds to start to loosen up a bit, find his rhythm. At the moment, it's Lewis scoring the points.
Yes, there's low leg kicks working from that right hand, just clipped him. And there's the danger for Lewis Stone.
Body lock position. Lewis Stone can take his back here.
Oh, that was a knee. West landed with the knee, and he knew it.
Some heavy hammer fists here, trying to finish it off. Lewis in the turtle position. He's going to try and roll and recover guard. There's the roll.
Yes, Paul West smells blood here. He caught him with the knee, saw the reaction. And Lewis Stone's done well to get to the position he has from that.
I think Lewis is complaining about something, but I couldn't spot what it was that Paul West did wrong.
No, the knee was certainly while they were upright. Maybe he was saying in those exchanges another knee came in, but the one that did the damage was certainly from an upright position.
Wow, very confident there. Paul West is standing in the pocket, blocking three hooks there.
Yes, psychologically you feel he's winning the fight as well. As you said, his demeanour and the way he conducts himself there, he just shrugged it off, as you said. It was must be quite intimidating when you're in there to see that.
Lewis's hands are a bit low for my liking.
Especially after having taken that knee, he's got to be careful. Jumping knee of his own now.
Oh, nice finish to the round there. Very close.
So round two of three.
Still feel like Paul West is holding back slightly here.
Yes, he stalks his man well. He gets in very good position. We know he's dangerous with those hands. I'd like to see him just set up that bolo punch a bit more. He's telegraphed it twice now at the end of the first and the beginning here of the second.
Yeah, or even straighten it up. He threw it nice and straight in the first round, which he landed, so I'd like to go back to that.
And one of the ways that Lewis Stone was keeping him away earlier were the leg kicks, and he acknowledges one himself there that came right across the bows from West.
Paul West switched stance there temporarily.
I feel like you though, Nick, you look at Paul West and you feel that there's so much more inside there, don't you? You're just waiting for it to explode out. He's shown us glimpses.
Definitely.
And with his demeanour, his confidence, you just feel it's ready to explode, but we just haven't quite seen it yet.
If he could just bring the power down to 70-80% instead of trying to get the knockout with one shot, I think we'd see a lot more of him.
He's stalking his man once more.
He covers up well in the pocket. He's just got to throw the counter afterwards.
And looking at the other side of the coin, what are your thoughts on Lewis Stone? Because he's weathered it quite well here, but in offensive terms, we haven't seen that much from him either.
No, his hands have been dropping recently, but I think he should start using his jab more, take advantage of his range, start picking off Paul West. Outwork him, outpoint score him.
Yes, West guarding against the knees that he knows are going to come from Stone.
Again, Paul West getting wrapped up because his head is too low, and now he's in a dangerous spot where he could eat some knees. So he can't afford to wait around there. He has to actively try and get out of that dangerous position.
Yes, Stone is beginning to throw them with some consistency now.
Any one of these knees can cut him and could end the fight potentially.
It's a strange tactic, Nick, because he's tried nothing to get out of it. And it shocked me because he's been in control for long periods of the fight. And here, he's just letting Lewis Stone bang the knees into him. And as you said, it's a very dangerous game. Now I just can't understand this at all.
I think it's just a little bit lacking technical know-how there on how to get out. He can't afford to be resting. I know he's a strong lad. He can just power off this, get his back off the cage, because he's losing the fight in the judges' eyes. It's not what he wants.
Yes, a strange tactic, especially when we've seen glimpses of what he's most definitely capable of.
He's letting it slip away minute by minute.
You start to think of the reasons why, and you wonder, is there enough gas in the tank? Is he pacing himself to make sure he goes the distance? Because these are very strange tactics in my book.
It's true, he doesn't appear to be tired, but you never know what's going on inside. Attempted trip there, and then they break away. Blocked the head kick, but again, not countering.
And Stone has grown in confidence during this round. Because of the attitude of his opponent here.
Yeah, what I'd like is, because he's booking very high, I'd like Lewis to throw a high shot and then drop down and throw a body shot, because his body is exposed when he blocks his punches. Again, wraps the head up. We've got to learn from this.
Well, you heard Paul West's corner excitement when he finally threw a right hand. I think they're as frustrated with him at the moment, Nick, as we are.
Yeah, he's obviously got a lot more than what he's showing.
And for me, these knees and the amount of time they spent on the cage there is actually quite clearly winning this round for Lewis Stone.
There you go, you can take his back. Now, last time he was in this position, he looked for the knee, which did some damage. Let's see what he goes for now. Scramble. Lewis spinning and rolling, trying to recover guard.
Yes, he managed to last time, and he managed to escape quite effectively, but for the first time in the round, a sustained attempt by Paul West here. And not before time, really.
He needs to concentrate on passing the guard before throwing the bombs. Otherwise, he's going to end up in between his legs. There you go. He's got side control. 10 seconds to go. He needs to unleash with the right arm. Non-stop elbows and hammer fists. Needs to try and steal the round or cause a cut.
Well, too little too late in my book for that round, Nick.
Absolutely. Third and final round here, and potentially one apiece.
You really like to think now, Nick, that someone would really go for it, because they must know how close this fight is.
Exactly, and this is a pro fight. After all, wins and losses make a big difference. They need to go after it. They need to take it seriously.
That's right. They've been through the semi-pro process. They've got their fights under their belt. As you said, now it's very important in the pro ranks to get those wins. And I really feel whichever man steps up the pace here can really take this fight now.
Lewis should be sticking that jab in his face. Instead, he's shortening his distance by throwing looping punches. It doesn't make sense to me.
Well, we've also seen that West is an effective boxer, yet he's walking his man down and not letting the leather go. As we see here again, this is the third and final round.
They've still got plenty in the gas tank by the looks of it.
Oh, there was a jumping Superman punch with the right hand that suddenly changed the whole complexion of this fight.
That came out of nowhere, and that was heard around the arena, that punch.
I mean, defensively though, Nick, Lewis Stone's proved quite adept, hasn't he, from these situations in the previous two rounds. And he's showing it again here.
His ground game has saved him a couple of occasions here. Done a good job. But, I mean, Paul West there, he shouldn't have allowed this to happen.
No,
he had him hurt. He should have gone in for the kill, in my opinion.
Superb Superman punch, but as you said, defensively He's allowed Lewis Stone back into it now.
Lewis throwing his legs high. Paul West shrugs him off. He should let him up at this stage and really put the pressure on now.
First signs maybe that there's not as much in the tank as we thought previously from both men.
Still, there's no excuse. This is pro now. They need to push themselves.
Cautious right hand there from Stone.
Who's going to throw the knee?
Well, it's a tired-looking offence from West as well. I hate to say it, but it looks like both men are close to being spent from that last exchange.
Paul West just invites his head to be wrapped up. Lewis might as well try standing guillotine. He's got that position so often now. Look, he's got the double underhooks and he's got to use them. He's got to suck them hips in. There's no point just stalling in these positions. Good, he gets the takedown. Now work, he's got to work.
Yes, I think we're looking at now which man is the least tired to take this. I think that Superman punch and what followed has given the edge to Paul West. It's what he can do here. But as you mentioned before, Nick, I think defensively Stone's ground game has helped him here. He's very good defensively on the ground. And he's needed to be.
Yeah, his guard game has saved him. Let's see if he can actually win it off his back now.
Well, that's the thing. Took the feet of West nicely there to get in this position.
He's got his back now, looking for the rear naked choke. Again, there's no real sense of urgency here.
West looking to scuttle out the back door, but it's not going to happen.
He should keep pounding him, and then he will find the choke appearance for itself.
This is Stone's big chance. He's got to take it now after the early initiative in this round was with Paul West. So Lewis Stone has really got to maximise this opportunity now.
Lewis should flatten him out and should kick his legs back, drive his hips down, flatten Paul West out.
West has been able to turn now.
Where are the elbows? The elbow should be raining down. Look, he's got one elbow in. His arm is trapped. He can't block. He needs to keep elbowing with the left arm. Powerful move to escape the mount.
Well, it was Stone's big opportunity and he failed to take it.
It's a bit too friendly for my liking. It's like, almost like a sparring match at this point.
It's almost like they've settled for going the distance now. They've had their moments, especially West with that Superman punch. But you're right, Nick, it seems to have settled down into a familiar little pattern that. But it's a bit disappointing, to be honest. With 10 seconds to go, neither man's going to risk something really serious now.
Hands by the waist there.
Tough one to call. That third round went West's way. Stone came back, but neither man really went for the throat and the win there. So it'll be interesting to see how the judges decide this.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the judges' scorecards. The judges have scored 29-28, 30-27, 29-28 for unanimous decision for the Blue Team.